curves adjustment can be really intimidating, but today I'm going to break it down for you so that you can see how simple it actually is to use.
I think that this is an excellent lens.
Well, hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Emma, and professionally I'm a software developer, but in my free time I love landscape photography and making related videos here on YouTube. In today's video, I'm going to show you the basics of the curves adjustment in Affinity Photo. It looks really intimidating, but what I'll show you is how to adjust the contrast and the exposure of your photo in a very fine detailed manner, and how that's actually pretty simple to do if you know what you're doing. I don't want it to be too long and complicated of a video, so I will save the more in-depth and complex features of the curves adjustment for later videos and just start you off with the basics today. I will be showing you the curves adjustment using this photo that I took in my video that came out last week, and so if you haven't seen that video, definitely check it out after this. So I've got the photo opened up in Affinity Photo on my Mac now, and it already has my adjustments from last week applied to it, and I'm just going to show you how we can add that curves adjustment on there as a finishing touch to this. Now I already have the curves adjustment from last week on here, and so I've just unchecked that, and I'll show you how to add another one. You can find the curves adjustment in the adjustments tool panel on the right side, and it's about halfway down. You can open that up and just click on default to make a new curves adjustment. I'm just going to move it up to the top layer. So when I open this up, you can see that it's basically a graph here. And we have this diagonal line right here, and then behind it what we have is actually a copy of the histogram. If I click over here, you can see that this is the histogram for the image, and it matches up with the background of this curves adjustment. If you're not familiar with a histogram, it's basically an XY graph representing the brightness of different pixels in the image. And so your horizontal x-axis is the brightness of the pixels in that range, and then the vertical y-axis is showing you how many pixels there are at that brightness. And so what this histogram is showing me is that most of my image is fairly dark. So over here toward the left side of the graph, where the dark pixels are, you've got these really tall lines that's showing me there's lots of dark pixels there. And then they kind of taper off as we go to the right. And over here where the really bright pixels are, you can see that there's really no line at all, showing me that there aren't a lot of really bright pixels in the image. And that makes sense for this image, because if you look at the image, it is mostly this really dark mud, and the brightest spot is kind of this leaf here, which looks really bright against the mud, but it's really not a full white as we would have all the way on the right side. The diagonal line on here is actually the curves adjustment, and that's what we can make changes to. It runs from the left side, which represents the black pixels in the bottom left corner that represents black, to the top right corner, which represents white. And there's points on this line, and I can adjust them. So there's already one on black here. And if I were to pull that up, you can see that the line follows it. And as I go up, the image gets brighter. If I move it all the way up to the top here, the image is basically all white. If I put that back down and I moved the white one all the way down, the image becomes all black. And when it's at this diagonal line from corner to corner with a slope of one here, that's where your picture is unchanged. So how can we actually make use of this curves adjustment now that we know what it is? Well, I can click on this line, and when I do that, it will add a new point. Now I can move that point around, and again, the line follows it. And so I can brighten or darken the image from that point. The line follows it so that it gives us a nice smooth roll off between where we've changed the exposure and the surrounding area so that we don't have any harsh lines in the photo. And you can make as many points as you want to on the line. If you want to get rid of them, you can just click on the point and press the backspace key, and that'll get rid of that point for you. So in this image, what I want to do is I want to make the leaf stand out a little bit more from the background. So I've got this kind of brighter leaf and this darker background, but they're a little bit more even tone right now. I want that leaf to really kind of pop out in the background to kind of be darkened down a little bit, but not too much, just kind of a tiny bit, okay? And so what I can do to start out here is I'm just going to pull up the exposure in the brighter parts of the image by clicking over here and pulling this area up. And I can use the histogram at the bottom actually as a reference, so I know if I pull up too far over to the right, I'm not really changing anything because there aren't pixels at that brightness. So I'm just going to click somewhere over here and pull that up. But now I've pretty much brightened the whole image, which remember isn't what I wanted. I just want to brighten up the leaf. So what I'll do is add more points on the line, and I'll just kind of pull them down so that the darker portion of the image isn't actually changed that much, and actually darken it down just a tiny bit, something like this. So we've got kind of an S curve going here, which is typically what you want to do if you're increasing contrast in your photo, is add a little bit of an S curve. But this lets me adjust it very specifically, so I can make just the brighter part where the leaf is, I can really pull the brightness of that section up without affecting the other parts of the photo too much. And then I can kind of darken down the background just slightly, but not too much. And so I'm just going to go for maybe something like that. And so you can see here's what the image looked like previously, and here's with that curves adjustment applied to it. It just gives it a nice contrast and makes it pop out a little bit more. I've exposed the leaf a little bit more while darkening the background down a little bit. Now, you might of course notice at this point that you could make these changes using a contrast adjustment or a shadows and highlights adjustment. Those are both kind of simpler ways of adjusting the same thing. So why would you want to use the curves adjustment? Well, the curves adjustment, while it feels slightly more complicated, it gives you just a little bit more power over the fine tuning of this. And so if you were to use the contrast of the shadows and highlights, you don't get that fine detail to really be able to pick out the exposure range of the image that you want to adjust. It applies to the image in a much more general way and gives you a lot less control. For a lot of images, that works really well, and you can just quickly adjust your contrast by adding that contrast adjustment and bringing the contrast slider up. But for some images, you really need to gain that extra control, and that's where you can use the curves adjustment to get a better handle on things. So that's all that I want to share about the curves adjustment for today. Like I said, there's a lot more power here available in the curves adjustment, but I don't want to just fire hose information on you and have you be totally confused. I want to keep this video shorter and more concise, and so I'm going to save more information about this hopefully for future videos. So if you did enjoy this video and if it helped you, don't forget to hit the like button on your way out and to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss more videos that I'm really excited to share with you in the future. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.